take things for what they are. In this game, since we're talking about money, and most people are very undisciplined to it, you will hear people say things, and then they will try to backtrack. So one of the first things you're going to hear in business is people, when you don't want to buy their shit, they're going to say something real slick. So it might be, you know, Freeman, but everybody has this stuff already. And I don't get it. What don't you understand? And what you talking about? You know, if I say it don't work for me, then the cat get mad and say, you know, he's trying to imply that I must be stupid. But since you're the cat who came up with this money and understand money and understand how to make it, it's going to be a lot of motherfuckers that really want you to be stupid with your chips and then give it over to them. So they're doing dumbass deals. And most ignorant motherfuckers in this game do. Especially because most people prey on black brothers. They prey on black businesses because most of you bitch ass motherfuckers want to get put on so goddamn much that you want to align yourself with Chase and Citibank and whoever else can endorse your bitch ass because you're not strong enough to raise your own business. So most people in this game, since they aren't disciplined, they will present to you their evil intentions. You know what I mean? You got to learn to accept them when you see them. I think most people in this game don't want to see them. So if me and you are in business, young homie, I don't know you, you don't know me. And my brother comes in and says, fuck this motherfucker. And then he leaves out the door. And then I say, hey, yo, don't sweat my brother. You know what I'm saying? He just get a little bit agitated. Now, the bitch in you would say, yeah, I got a brother like that who say, you know, say some wild shit. And then the man in me gonna say, well, that's what that motherfucker think. Since you related to that motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Then you might think that on the low, and your brother just so undisciplined that he fucking came out and said it. See, I'm gonna accept the shit the way it is, the way the motherfucker said it to me. Now, this is gonna cause you a lot of problems in your life, because most women are slick-tongued with what they really think. And when you catch them on it, then most of you bitch motherfuckers, soft dick motherfuckers, always turn around and saying, yo, you know, I forgave her for that. And what the fuck you forgave her for? She said it out her mouth. See, the reason why I tell you it's going to be hard on you is because this is the majority of people. You know what I'm saying? You're going to lose a lot of your friends. Because once you hear it, you hear it. See, the thing I tell my nephew about this chip game at all times, people say what they mean at all times. You got to accept it. Most of these motherfuckers ain't your friends. You know what I'm saying? Most of these people out here don't really want the best for you. Now, if they would just be a man and or be a woman and we come into this chip game and you try to make your deal and I try to make my deal, there's no friendship here. There's no loyalty. There's no love. I'm good. It's only when motherfuckers are trying to deceive you that they slip up. A long time ago, one of the cats I was rolling with, I think I told you this story before on a previous podcast, where the cat told me one time, you know, Freeman, if I get married, I don't want you to be around. So, you know, he wasn't even joking either. So, you know, I kind of took that in stride. I heard it. I don't know if the bitch motherfucker knew I heard it, but I took it in stride. And then, you know, never caught up with that cat ever again. Ever. To this day. You know what I mean? And the cat was trying to get through to me through other means and channels. But you got to understand something, like I'm trying to say with my nephew. People, if they're good people, they don't have nothing bad to say. You know what I'm saying? They don't have anything angry or fly or slick tongue to say. That's truly who they are. They don't care. You know, evil people, they cover the shit up because that's what they truly believe. So when I walk into a business place, I got to cover up my true feelings because I don't want to work for these motherfuckers. You understand what I'm saying? I'm not on their team, but I got to cover it up. So I cover it up by not lying, by being silent, not having a lot to say, not volunteering a lot of shit, and keeping my life separate from that shit. You understand what I mean? And then when you do that, people usually trust the person that's quiet. You know what I'm saying? So then you end up knowing how these motherfuckers truthfully feel. I remember I was in one spot and the lady was like, yeah, you know, Freeman, you know your true value. So, you know, don't tell anybody else. I'm like, this goddamn devil's trying to tell me how to cover it up so other people can't hear. But what she did was she thought I was a devil like her. So she thought she can tell me about her devilish ways and I wouldn't hold it against her. But I already knew, but it just confirmed that I said, this bitch can't be trusted, homie. In this chip game, motherfuckers can't be trusted. Women, men, dogs, cats, mouse rats, homie, it can't be trusted. You know what I'm saying? You got to learn to see things for what they are. And a lot of motherfuckers get their heart broke over this shit, homie. You got to be able, when you get in this chip game, homie, and you do a lot of transactions, you got to be able to spot that this motherfucker ain't really on nobody's team. You got to be able to spot that as soon as his pockets get green, he gone. You got to be able to spot that these motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying, are just here for a second. You understand what I mean? And you got to be able to run with that. Then you're going to learn to respect the dudes who are genuine about this chip game and just want to get the transaction done, ain't trying to bullshit you, ain't trying to lie to you, ain't trying to hold your hand, ain't trying to tell you, try to find something in common with you. You understand what I mean? You're gonna respect them for being a man or a woman, an adult in this chip game and stating what they got to do and moving on. See, a lot of us as black people, we look, the majority of us, because we still want to be accepted. The majority of us, we don't want to see what we see. When you're on the rise and grind, you listen to me on a podcast, Young Partner, right now. A lot of the things that I said over the past couple of years, homie, you knew already in your heart. You just haven't heard somebody else say it. So as a result of you not hearing everybody else say it, but we know we all believe it, then who are you dealing with when you talk to people outside on the street? Who are you talking to? You know what I'm saying? When you watch TV and the black people are like, you know, I hate, Barack Obama doesn't do anything for black people. You know, what is that, their inner jealousy? You got to understand something, homie. When Bush was in office, none of them bitches said anything. You understand? I mean, that's why I get fucked up mad at them. I'm like, shut your punk ass up, homie. The only reason why you making a stink about this shit right now is because he's black. But if he was white, you shut the fuck up. So now you know that this kind of motherfucker who has this kind of problem against the president, who he know he ain't gonna never meet, ain't never gonna be a rival to, ain't even on the level of Barack Obama, has a problem with black people who are bigger than them. That's just me taking notes on a bitch, homie. You understand what I'm saying? When you go into a club, you sitting down with your partners, and you take notes on women, homie. You take notes on other dudes. I walk into the place, I scan motherfuckers. Who mean mugging? Who's showing off? You know what I'm saying? Who probably gay on a down low and shit, all these weird old motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? Who got some foot fetishes in this motherfucker? Then I look at the women. Who insecure? Who overconfident? Who real thirsty? Well, you know, I'm dry mouth on this motherfucker. Who really coming out here trying to find someone to be with for the night? Who really coming out here trying to be with someone for the rest of their life? I mean, you know what I'm saying? I'm signing the motherfuckers up. I'm trying to talk to them, see where their head at. You know what I'm saying? See what's going on. I'm going to give you something special. I was out a couple of nights ago. Fucking, it was Friday, man, just after Thanksgiving. And I was out chilling, right? And this woman I was sitting next to, she was like, you know, she's not from here, I'm not from here. You know, I was in another city. And I'm chilling there, and I said, you know, she's black, of course. And I told her, I said, you know, no, I live in the black neighborhood. You know, if I move over, you know, when I come to visit, I'm always around black people. And she was like, that's kind of uncommon. I said, why is that uncommon? I'm black, they black. Why the hell would I be? You understand what I'm saying? So it's, look, what she got to learn from me is that I like black people. I ain't scared of my own people. I'm going to be around my own people. I never met a motherfucker. You don't see Chinese people walking in black neighborhoods saying, I feel good. I don't know why a black man should walk around white, Jews, Japanese, whoever neighborhood acting like he cool. So it's uncommon because she never met a black person who told her that I actually prefer black people, that I like black people. I love black people. They're my people. You understand what I'm saying? So she thought it was uncommon, which really fucked me up in the brain because I'm uncommon. She was looking for the right words. You know what I'm saying? That's how fucked up black people are as a whole, that me liking black people is uncommon. But what I'm trying to say is I presented her with the truth. Uncut. I don't know her. Uncut. Here's what I'm thinking. And most of the time, you know, motherfuckers, oh, you know, you should try to, you know, because most of you cats who like to run game on motherfuckers, the reason why you have to run so much game is because you're not who you are at your heart. See, a motherfucker got to put on a clown face in order to entertain. A motherfucker got to put on a basketball jersey in order to be considered a basketball player. But you know what I'm saying? If you were that dude by yourself, then all those things are in you and you aren't there yet. That's why you keep putting on masks. That's why the BMW speak for you. That's why all this shit speak for you, because you ain't strong enough to speak for yourself. So I presented the truth. She accepted the truth. She thought it was weird. Like I said, if the majority of black people feel that way, that we like each other, but we don't say it out loud, then who the fuck are we talking to? Who the fuck are you rolling with? See, I use cues against motherfuckers. And I know people don't like it, but that's just the way the game is. When you make money, homie, you got to monitor motherfuckers. You got to keep them, you know what I'm saying, what is his tendency? Some motherfuckers like women too much. And if women were, you know what I'm saying, set him up, he gone. Some motherfuckers want to do drugs so much they think to be able to do death, smoke death, drink death means they're tough. You got to keep track of all these personalities. And the best thing about most motherfuckers is, especially amongst men, see, when you're rolling with the brothers, you, especially amongst men, dudes tell you. See, they consider it to be part of their fucked up manhood, but they tell you, yeah, I like strippers, man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I love pink satin panties, man. You know what I'm saying? I like drinking Grand Marnier, homie. You know what I'm saying? All these motherfuckers love to tell you all their bitch ass shit. So you gotta accept the truth that come from them. And then you gotta take two steps back and see the bitch in action. See, for me, like I said, I accept who they are. I think motherfuckers don't, they get mad at me because realistically, if you a foul motherfucker, I don't want you around me, man. Foul motherfuckers are weak. They accepted a weak part of their life and that's what they're doing. Strong people, you know what I'm saying? You might catch me at a strip club, not anymore, but you could have caught me there in the past when I was rolling with my partners out to a certain spot. But I ain't gonna never bring it up like, yeah, Freeman, the best one is over there on the north side. I don't know what the best one is. Shit is weird. So, like I said, man, you gotta accept the truth. You know what I'm saying? What you see, how they present it every damn moment. If a girl don't like you, get the fuck up and walk away. Why are you trying to convince her ass? You know what I'm saying? Shake the spot. I remember I was in D.C. and one girl I was talking to her at some club and she was like kind of foul, you know, foul not cursing, but foul like she ain't feeling me. So I just told her, I said, hey, it was nice meeting you. Turned around and left. She got so shocked. She came back up to me. You just give up that easy? I said, I don't give up. You don't like me? I'm gonna move on. What the fuck am I trying to convince your ass for? So I accept things for what they are, homie. The sun's not coming out. I better put on a jacket. The sun's coming out and there's no clouds in the sky. I better dress light. You dig what I'm saying? People staring at me on a corner. I'm looking at them motherfuckers in the faces. I'm keeping track of the motherfuckers who are looking at me. So I'm looking at them the same way. And if I ever see them around my way, in my vicinity, around where I dwell and bell and live, I'm ready to go. No hesitation. You understand what I'm saying? See, in this game, we always talk about recon. But you got to recon the truth, homie. You got to find out the truth. You got to dig for the truth. And the truth of the matter is most of these motherfuckers have ulterior motives. And the only cats you're going to meet who don't have ulterior motives is the motherfucker who's self-contained, already got his shit. You've been listening to me on this podcast for years. I've told you where I live, how I live, where I grew a business, where I happen to be, streets, all kind of shit, food places. I'm telling you the whole thing of my life because I don't got nothing to hide. You know what I'm saying? I ain't hiding in some holes like some mole, you know what I'm saying, in this game. I'm going to tell you what's really popping. Primarily because I got my own shit, and I'm going to do my own shit, and I don't give a fuck. You understand what I'm saying? So I can give you the truth. Now, any man who don't have all that shit, you got to watch out. And this ain't about accumulation of material possession. This is accumulation of security and independence. Most of these motherfuckers don't have security and independence. Most of these motherfuckers, you know, he's two chip paychecks away from losing it all. I'm like, damn, man, maybe you should double up on your goddamn car payment or triple up, quadruple up on your car payment so you won't be two checks away. You know what I'm saying? So you won't have all them problems. But the thing is, what I want you to get, homie, is in this game, because we're dealing with money, and since so many motherfuckers don't know how to make money, then what they are going to come at you with is a lie, a con. But if you get to know them, they're going to tell you the truth. And if you frustrate them, this is what I want you to know about business. Anybody trying to sell you something, make them prove it. See if he get frustrated. If he get frustrated, you're going to see the anger build up in his face. And if the anger builds up in his face, don't do business with him. You understand what I'm saying? You just tell him, all you got to do to frustrate any motherfucker is say, I don't get it. I don't understand. I don't think this is going to work for me. I don't see how it works for me. You know what I'm saying? Until I see how it works for me, I'm not going to do it. Now, if it's a true dude who really know what he's talking about, he going to explain it to you. He going to break out a pen and paper if he got to. If it's a fuck-ass dude who don't know who's trying to con you, he don't got shit for you. He just going to get mad. You know what I'm saying? He probably going to go, oh, man, you wasting my time. See, The motherfucker, you know, when you true to your shit, man, you can explain it. And when somebody don't understand it, guess what? You're going to sit there and try to make them understand. But not in some con-ass way, but in a simple way. It's like this, man. You know, you buy the product from me. We do this. You get 10% off the top. This is how we're going to pay you back. It's simple. Blah, blah, blah. How do you think it's not going to work for you? Okay, this is where you're making a mistake in how you see in the game. Blah, blah, blah. You got to accept things for what they are, homie. So many of you cats get disappointed. You have friends that double cross you, triple cross you, quadruple cross you. You understand what I'm saying? You got cats who should have put you on. You got cats who told you when he make it, he gonna pull you with him. You got cats who said, you know, that they got love for you. And then I hear all this shit sound like a whole bunch of women crying on a goddamn thing like Mahatma Gandhi died or some motherfucker crying. You know what I'm saying? Like North Korea, them Korean ooh, girl ooh, shit all on the news because y'all motherfuckers crying because somebody, you got to spot check cats when it comes to these chips, partner, and you got to keep your eyes open. You got to gather data on them. See, what nobody ever understands about this chip game, homie, is it changes weak motherfuckers. It enhances strong ones. So for a weak dude, he'll all the promises he made, he ain't going to keep them. For a strong dude, all the promise he made, he is going to keep them. So you got to know when money come in hand, homie. And it's simple. You knew this when you were a little kid, homie. That's how at the root of this shit you can be on these motherfuckers. If you were the dude that used to run with cats when y'all were like early teenagers, junior high, and he was the dude trying to steal from you, he's still a thief. If he was the dude who was still salting you up with women, he's still salting you up, homie. If he was the dude who would jump in front of you in line, that motherfucker still gonna jump in front of you in line. If that motherfucker was a bully, he's still a bully. You understand what I'm saying? The true nature didn't change. In fact, when they were kids, they were even more of who the fuck they were. Now they're grown men. They got goddamn lies going. So for me, I accept motherfuckers for what they are. Now this whole podcast, as I was just rolling down the street, went to pick up something to eat, came back, right? And I saw these dudes, you know, nothing heavy, just a couple of cats look like they're hanging out around. But, you know, as I drove up, all of them looked at me. You see what I'm saying? Now, most cats will say, oh man, Freeman, you just fucking paranoid. True, right? But God knows I got out of my car with my gun on my side ready to go. They didn't say nothing to me, I didn't say nothing to them. But you goddamn right, I kept my eye. I know all of them look like now. And if I ever see them near me again, we're going to have a problem. Now, we'll see if it was just them posting up on a block. That's normal. Or we'll see if I really got motherfuckers plotting on me. See, a lot of cats don't see it. You get out your car, you don't see these motherfuckers staring you down. You get out your car, you don't see motherfuckers plotting on you. You get out your car, you don't think that motherfuckers have this kind of hate for you for nothing. I don't put it past anybody. You understand what I mean? We can be in the middle of church, and if you look at me sideways, motherfucker, I'm bringing hell with me. You understand what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck where we happen to be. I don't care if Jesus standing next to you. Now, I've grown up with this, what you may call paranoia, or what I consider to be a sixth sense, third eye shit, since I was a kid. You know what I'm saying? I've been able to feel the heat coming off of an Eagleville motherfucker since I was a kid. So I accept things for what they are, not how they present themselves to be. And you gotta learn to do that shit ASAP. We entering into grown man games with grown man chips, partner. We not entering into that kiddie shit. Nobody wanna fuck your girl, homie. Drop all that little shit. You know what I'm saying? You got grown men out here worried about if somebody wanna fuck their girl, homie. The fuck I care. You know what I'm saying? Motherfucker want retread tires. Homie, I don't go after retread tires. So you gotta know that keep your eyes open for all the shit around you. And your hunch, your first thought, that funny feeling you have is right, partner. Don't pass it up. It's better to be prepared than dead. You know what I'm saying? I think I said this on another podcast. Me and my homies talking about it. And one of my buddies was like, man, it's better to be scared than dead, homie. That's the truth. It's better to be prepared, paranoid, scared than dead. You understand what I'm saying? So if I overreact to a situation, it's better than underreacting. What I'm trying to get you in this chip game, homie, because you got to use the instincts that God gave us. Something is wrong here. You ever walk outside or something, like something is wrong here? I knew something was about to pop. How many of us been into a club or some kind of spot where it's about to start busting on motherfuckers and you felt it, you saw it? Now, did you shake the spot? Did you get your homies and roll out? I did. Probably about 5 minutes before motherfuckers got shot. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm asking you at all times, homie, accept things for what they are. Trust yourself. And listen to these sloppy, undisciplined motherfuckers talk about this chip game. And you'll see where they're coming from. It ain't paranoia. It's being prepared. Next time, partner.